PSP AudioWare Hertzrider 2 on drums. What can you do with it? I found that this plugin can work really well as a drum fattener and as a problem fixer on drums. In this video, I will show you how. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Now, I love plugins which are useful in mixes. And I must admit, at first I thought this plugin was only for modulation effects. I was wrong. See, the Hertzrider can be used for that for sure, but it's actually a really powerful mixing tool on drums. I'll demonstrate the plugin on drums as a drum mix fattener and a problem fixer. Okay, let's start with kick, snare and a bass synth. The kick sounds fine, but let's use it together with this synth to show you how to use Hertzrider 2 as a problem fixer. The bass synth has energy around 92 Hz and 30 Hz. The kick has a lot of energy around 92 Hz and 34 Hz. These are conflicting areas and will either build up in these areas or phase cancel. To make it work, you can EQ or do something like sidechain ducking. But I will use the Hertzrider 2 plugin to shift the frequency of the fundamental of the bass drum. See, if I turn the shift, you can also see the low end sweeping. I found the sweet spot for this bass drum to be around minus 35 with the range set to 3k. Now I have moved the problematic bass drum frequency out of the way to a lower frequency area. I would add some high passing because the sub lows are now even below 20 Hz. Because the Hertzrider keeps the audio sounding natural, this is a really elegant solution. On snare drum, the shifting can be used to make a higher pitched snare really thick and fat while keeping its character. The sweet spot for this snare is around minus 74 with the range set to 1k. Makes it really fat. If I would pitch shift the entire snare, it would not sound as good. Let me show you. Not as good by far as the Hertzrider method. Now let me show you how little the Hertzrider affects the higher frequency of this snare. This is Hertzrider with a high pass, and this is the high pass without Hertzrider. You hear a little shift in frequencies, but it stays pretty much intact and the attack is the same. Now, because you are fiddling with frequencies, always do a phase flip check to see if you got issues there. I leave it as it is. It seems interesting to use this fatter snare in parallel by using the mix knob, but I found it got really grainy. Too much to be usable in a normal mix on this snare. But if you want a lo-fi effect, this can be useful for that. And I also found that Hertzrider 2 can be excellent for breathing more life in flat sounding toms. You use the envelope filter for that. The envelope filter will shift the frequencies for a certain amount of time. And since this plugin leaves the attack intact while creating a sound which is much alike when you downtune the bottom skin of a tom, creating a pitch down effect. This sounds fatter and a bit more aggressive. With the time and mod knobs, you fine-tune the speed of the envelope to have it sound natural. And with the shift knobs, you can shift the tone of the drum back to where it was before using Hertz Rider. And the Hertz Rider can also make a mono room mix sound stereo. For that, you simply use the Hertz Rider in stereo on a mono source. I copied the mono room mix to a stereo track, and I shift left and right channels differently. You can hear it getting wider. I do add a high pass to make sure the low end is mono compatible. And I high pass the sides of the mid sides more than the mid. These are the drums with all Hertz Riders enabled. And here are the drums with all Hertz Riders disabled. The Hertz Rider is a great tool for drum sound fixing, drum mixing and drum tweaking in a way you wouldn't expect at first. This one will be in my plugin toolkit for sure. Watch my Hertz Rider review for more applications of this plugin. The link is in the video description. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!